lot of times when I, when we talk about, you know, when you've been traveling, you've been talking to so many people, you forget what you said you're doing.
Yes.
Yes. From him to his sister, you know, it's a house hunting letter, saying, eventually, this is the school.
All right.
Was built as the school. And it's. Are you going in?
Hello.
So George and Dragon was the other pub, and Darwin met villagers. Come in areas where there's chalk, because the flints form deep in the chalk. Yes. This was was put on very recently because this is pregnant, and she gave birth within a week of arrival, and then
and that baby died.
Infant died.
Yeah, September 23rd, October 16th.
Fortnight later, I think. Mm-hmm. Wonderful one.
Right, that's your aunt.
My aunt, my grandmother's aunt.
Your grandmother's aunt.
Yes. And she, I can't imagine that. Body is here. They're probably
this is just a memorial
ashes
stone.
Or,
yes.
Was buried here a year before Darwin died, and there's an extraordinary account of the funeral, and Francis, the son, remembered seeing his father standing at the grave, looking into it. Mm-hmm. The son feeling he's thinking
of his own mortality.
Yes.
Right. Well, Raz was Charles was very fond of his brother. They lived together in Darwin's
they buried,
were such that
yes, Raz was a sort of very lonely bachelor who lived in
and the children all were politely giggling at that.
Yes. Yeah. Towards us and the bay window he built. So, the house he bought.
Right.
The man, Buxton Brown. How Darwin had it all. And then also just advise about the garden. And refilled with all the old furniture. And they also then decided that certain parts of the collection.
This tribe was here before as
yes,
well.
Yes,
I think.
And there's a watercolour from the 1830s of a view of the house from over there that shows. Obviously just been taken out by Emma because the photographer had come for the day.
Uh-huh. And he looked a little bit grumpy.
And this is a facsimile,
the
cabinet, but is in the summer when plants are growing.
Yes, and you see it's up there in some kind of showcase, they slid down on the thing. Yes.
Yeah, the whole the study.
Mm-hmm.
Better in right now. Das Kaffee.
photographer.
Right.
And
so she
asked them to write it.
And Charles?
Yes. And shows you. These pictures.
That's very nice.
The
chairs are original.
Yes. And then.
Did he have a? He didn't have a toilet back there, too, did he?
He would have done. No, he would. And when. And because I mean, it must have been given back,
mm-hmm.
and it is. It's Darwin wrote about the microscope stool that when he and Etty would come in and Darwin wasn't there,
mm-hmm.
the two of them would sit on the stool and pump themselves
and play around.
round the room with his walking stick.
Right.
And that, yeah. I think.
Well, the story that you write in Andy's box about Darwin being perfectly happy to interrupt his work.
Yes.
A child came in and, you know,
yes.
needed something, wanted something, just wanted to talk.
Finished barnacles,
mm-hmm.
Began sorting notes on species theory.
Uh-huh.
And the sorting you then see in the photograph that they took of this room before
mm-hmm.
Darwin, before he moved to the
mm-hmm.
newer study. That is actually
that is the cupboard in which it was kept.
Yes,
that's fabulous. It won't photograph, but it's still wonderful.
Darwin kept all the old papers,
mm-hmm.
and
thank God he was such a pack rat.
Yes, exactly. And then the grandchildren rather, used that cupboard as their changing room, because when they were here, when they came for their summer holidays, when Emma was here in her widowhood, they would put on plays for the servants and
uh-huh.
the others.
Although you did write about the Darwins being fairly relaxed about
that. Yes, yes.
Which
yes.
could also argue that people played. This helps.
Yes.
Still.
If you see in the photographs, is that? Yes.
It looks like those are plane trees, correct?
To be able to eat a berry.
Yes.
And feel that.
Yes. That continuity. And that's pretty wonderful.
And there was a little plot along there, which was one of Darwin's experiments.
Yes. One different plant species lived there, and
mm-hmm.
we've counted 19 now. Irene and her friends have done a plot.
Just goes into blurry mode and decides that it's going to be blurry.
And
so,
you read about Darwin. And Darwin did a wonderful
for that one. He
uh-huh.
he thought, gosh, they seem to have some kind of behavior. And it's
sunk down that much.
No, it's that is. You see, it will be moving.
That is the original.
It
was
really shocked.
Yes.
It had been moved.
We moved.
Here's the kitchen garden, and
it does go on for quite a ways, doesn't it?
Yes.
But then they were, as you pointed out in your book, they were feeding 20 odd people.
Yes.
And so, you know, when you think about how much they had to grow here,
yeah.
that was quite astonishing.
Yes. Darwin, the garden was Emma's,
mm-hmm.
and the kitchen garden, particularly was where she had to make sure that the vegetables were grown for the household. Mm-hmm. And Darwin was allowed a small area for his experimental beds. And he was given this little enclosure here.
Another one closest to
which was closest to the greenhouse, where he did his propagation and his animation and everything like that. Mm-hmm. And you always crossbreed. And then, so he did primula here. And then work on sweet peas. He really got going on the botany. He built the greenhouse.
Nice and warm.
Heated section, and then
this was heated.
This was so that he could. No. There's a boiler on. There's
sauna. Why about that? Heat or what?
No, it's hot water.
Or hot water.
Yes, okay, so it's not. Uh-huh. And then plant movement to light, gravity, the other side. Mm-hmm. And he was sent it by his American friend Asa Gray,
right.
And had it under observation, and he discovered that it did a very, very strange thing, which was instead of the tendrils, instead of growing towards the light, when they found some darkness, they went into it. Mm-hmm. And he found that because he had a piece of string hanging on the wall, and he saw that one tendril had sort of got into it and then had got inside, and so he put a piece of string which this efforts to reproduce, and discovered that this was an absolute pattern of behaviour, and he then wrote to Asa Gray and said, could you please tell me where this plant grows, and because it does this strange thing.
Yeah,
Asa Gray wrote back to say, yes, it grows in these Florida swamps where the trees that it has to climb up are all covered in moss. Huh. So if it's going to attach itself, uh-huh, it needs
it's looking
to get in. So it's just flipped. Yeah. It's in sun.
Oh, this was also
here. This is an observation hive for bees. They come in through that hole.
Yes.
And he had this big, big problem.
Just depending upon standards.
Yes. You
know, what is considered the best cow or the best bull?
Yes.
It was a wonderful series of pictures.
Yes. Yes.
What you were talking.
Yes. And here you see, uh-huh, and then these
to attack a bumblebee
nest
that doesn't
underground.
Seem right to me, right?
This one was the
one
that had
down
to be,
right,
because of that decay. They kept this one up so that you could see it. This was originally like that.
Mm-hmm.
Her with her wide skirt.
Mm-hmm.
And they wanted a dry path because, to walk in the wet.
Sure.
And so he had his encyclopedia of gardening, which included a section on garden paths.
Mm-hmm.
And there was a recipe for how to produce make a dry path. Some scientists, some successful scientists, out
right
of the other.
Right.
And this you see here.
To it.
Yes. Yes.
And so she's got footage of walking through a big chunk of that section.
Yes.
Of,
yes. The children playing, their sand pit was just here.
Mm-hmm.
And
and that was a little shelter that,
yes,
that she
yes
had.
Yes.
That was very nice.
Yes.
Uh-huh.
Yes,
I hadn't realized that this was on a ridge, and that does make a difference in terms of the topography and drainage.
Yes,
and,
yes, yes. One of Don and Emma's favorite places of all was a place they called the Terrace, which is, you see there's a line of trees along there.
Yes.
Just below it, uh-huh, the land falls deeply down, and he, as a little boy, I think he was down a sort of six, Vernon was six or seven, 1986, I think, when he died. And he had these memories. And less developed larvae, which at the 5th at 5 p.m. had been put on pasteboard and kept since in passage hall. The passage we walked into was on the outside of the house, had no windows, and so it was consistently cool and shaded. Mm-hmm. And he used that as a place with a uniform temperature that he could understand. And when Mrs. Darwin welcomed the next genteel visitor to the house, they would have to walk in through the door with...
July 18th, 1856. May
17th, 1857. Yes, and then what he does is there are some of the parts are dominant and prevail over the others. View of something incorporated in the view of natural selection, for natural selection acts by either not adapting as a or by. Hence, in fact, the law of the conditions of existence is the highest law, as it includes, through inheritance of former adaptations, that of unity of type. To keep the nibs, which were plucked from the geese in the backyard. You cut the nibs and then keep them sharp.
So she would not have been given the metal nibs, or she would not have been able to use the metal nibs all the time?
I think it was a time when they were sort of, you know, they were moving from one to the other.
Moving.
And then what really struck me, what hooked me, was this note. I found the box, so realised something about what it might be. And then when I unfolded the note and saw that it was Darwin's writing and saw how carefully he'd been looking, you know, managing her, the treatment, then watching her condition.
Just so sad.
Pan across it.
That's what I was thinking. But I was worrying with the light from the window from that direction, maybe that might create a glare. Francis had three wives?
Yes.
Slide. Right, that's wonderful.
And my first encounter with Darwin was sliding down that in my grandparents' home.
Okay. Your grandparents got the slide.
Yes. Very good. That's why Stephen has it. It came down to my grandmother. They haven't got the... I'm not happy with it as a way of... These are some of the best photographs. That's the only picture of Darwin with another person. Yes.
They did that very well in the movie, by the way.
Yes, that's the one of Henrietta, which you just saw up there. That way you can hold it and write. And when he, in London, all the London notebooks are written that way.
Yeah.
And that's because...
He's not having
to hold it. It's on the page.
Portrait, not landscape.
Yes. And then once he's entered it into his other text, he then crosses out the passage to show that he's...
So we've got this one. We've got the one on display downstairs, which is actually the one that was sent to Lyle.
Right. And was stolen and then recovered.
And was stolen, unfortunately recovered. Yes. So aren't we lucky?
What a history.
And then we've also got...
I don't know whether we're coming along the car, because Mark wasn't with us. We discussed how Darwin House is on
the field on that path that we saw, that public
path.
Of
the field
boundaries have changed a
little bit. The path of
that's quite honest. I'm sure that
there's a map of this whole area, valley and his Orcus Bank, because there was in 1840
areas that they walk through and graze periodically.
Yes, it's
tremendous biodiversity here. We've improved grassland, so they haven't had the fertilizers and nitrates.
Yes, exactly.
this is where all the Randall's. What is your relative, Ruth?
Oh, Ruth Pardell.
Yes. Is she a niece? What's the relationship?
She's a cousin.
A cousin, yes, that's right. No, yes. I couldn't guess it.
Yes.
This is where I stood with Ruth.